Breakfast is the most important meal of the day was just a marketing slogan coined in the 19th century by James Caleb Jackson and John Harvey Kellogg to sell their newly invented breakfast cereal to drive sales and popularity. And it's called breakfast since it's the first meal of the day since we have fasted overnight, right? If you choose not to eat breakfast, there's no reason to feel guilty since there isn't much evidence that skipping negatively impacts your health. However, I did want to go over 5 mistakes for those that do eat breakfast and why making these mistakes are actually hindering their goals, be it trimming their waistline, energy, and mood. So stay with me till the end. Also, real quick before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. I get that people are divided on this issue because the studies like this one here that shows us that breakfast skipping was associated with lower education and income seems like a pretty bold statement. But if you go down in the study where not a lot of people do in an area called conflict of interest, you'll find that authors received funding from General Mills. This really ticked a lot of people off, and understandably so, because if breakfast eaters tend to be healthier and leaner than breakfast skippers, you have to realize that this may only be true due to the possibility that breakfast eaters have other healthy lifestyle habits that are going on that the study in the literature didn't account for.
The problem with those studies is that breakfast skippers and breakfast eaters are different people. So maybe the breakfast eaters earn more money and exercise more, and that explains why they weigh less than the breakfast skipper.
So with that said, if you're like me and have breakfast from time to time and are on the fence, we should discuss some of the mistakes that get in the way of our health goals. The first mistake is skipping breakfast only to save calories. While it's true skipping breakfast means you'll save yourself some calories in the morning, but what kind of effect does that play out for the rest of the day? That's a good question to ask. Eating breakfast, on the other hand, according to a 2018 study published in Advances in Nutrition, found that compared with skipping breakfast, the addition of breakfast increased postprandial energy expenditure in most but not all studies. When extrapolated across 24 hours, the increase in postprandial energy expenditure after breakfast intake ranged from 40 to 200 calories and varied according to breakfast composition. And postprandial energy expenditure refers back to the amount of energy or calories you burn to digest and metabolize the food you eat. And when it comes to protein, protein actually utilizes more energy. If we go with the thermic effect of 30% for protein, this means that 100 calories of protein only end up as 70 usable calories. So that's the first mistake. The second mistake is limiting yourself to only the typical breakfast foods.
Every morning I need a good breakfast.
Right away, a big bite of toast.
For kids, like a square meal for breakfast.
A wonderful new fruit in the box cereal.
Who said breakfast has to be cereal, pancakes, donuts, and cinnamon rolls? In fact, most of our breakfasts are actually desserts if you think about it, since there is no color coming in from fruits and vegetables. There's a huge missed opportunity to get a ton of nutrients and fiber, especially early on in the day. The typical breakfast skews higher in carbohydrates and lower in protein compared to lunch. The best way to go about protein is to balance it out throughout the day. This will stimulate muscle protein synthesis more effectively, guys, compared to eating very little protein earlier in the day and loading up in the evening. So that was the second mistake. The third mistake is making breakfast the smallest meal of the day. In 2020, we had an intervention study published in the Journal of Clinical Endocrinology and Metabolism, which found that eating about 70% of your calorie needs at breakfast, 20% at lunch, and just 10% at dinner increased diet-induced thermogenesis, the calories burned after eating, by 2.5 times compared to eating 10% of total calories at breakfast, 20% at lunch, and 70% at dinner. This is why you have that quote that says, "Eat breakfast like a king, lunch like a prince, and dinner like a pauper." Maybe there was some science to that after all. The fourth mistake is eating breakfast when you're distracted, and I was actually waiting for a study like this to be published, and sure enough it did. Smartphone use while eating increases caloric ingestion. It was found that eating with distractors increased approximately 15% caloric ingestion. The best way to combat this is to become a mindful eater. Start paying attention to the food you're putting in your mouth. You'll likely enjoy the meal more and end up eating less without even trying. Plus, you'll end up chewing your food more, which increases postprandial diet-induced thermogenesis, according to this study. And lastly, juicing your fruit when you should be eating them whole. When fruit and vegetables are juiced, the majority of the fiber, a part of what makes them so healthy, is removed. It's the fiber that helps to keep us feeling fuller longer, not to forget to mention the three pathways that fiber has on the body: the hormonal effects, the intrinsic effects, and the caloric effects, which end up helping you reach your goals sooner. Now, I understand that the proponents of intermittent fasting will skip breakfast completely, especially if it's the 16-8 method, which involves having your first meal around noon. You can still reach remarkable results by doing this method of fasting. That's why I don't totally bash on skipping breakfast. And I made a video about it all right here, which you should definitely check out after this one. But again, it's important to mention that intermittent fasting does not suit everyone. The effects will vary by individual, and what works for someone else doesn't mean it will work for you or has to work for you. And that's okay too. If you're skipping breakfast and experiencing headaches, drops in blood sugar, faintness, and lack of concentration, you might have to hold off on intermittent fasting or change the duration or intervals. Also, keep in mind that not all studies that demonize skipping breakfast are made by the cereal companies. That's important to note too, since the cereal companies left a bad taste in our mouth and just have a ton of bad press. And in terms of what to eat, there's no one size fits all, right? But aim to include a source of protein, healthy fats, whole grains, and a vegetable or fruit that isn't juiced, as just an idea of what to look for in a complete breakfast. Coffee is another staple of our breakfasts too. It's a great source of antioxidants, but keep an eye out for added sugars and creamers. One of the first things you should do every morning before drinking coffee is actually drink 3 cups of water. The coffee should ideally come at least 90 minutes after waking up to allow your adenosine levels to rise slightly, making the caffeine more effective at blocking the receptors and keeping you alert better. Waiting 90 minutes to 2 hours after you wake up also helps to avoid crashing during the day as well. But I'm more curious to actually hear from you guys though. Do you partake in breakfast, skip breakfast, or don't think it matters? Let me know in the comments below. Also, hit the subscribe button if you found this video helpful. In the meantime, I'll see you on the next one.
Mmm, bacon and eggs and buttered toast. There's nothing like a good, healthy breakfast to start the day off right. And a meal like this should satisfy anyone. He'll have to learn that food has a lot to do with the way you look and the way you feel.